Hola guys and girls, and welcome to a kind of different Shoutout Life on my channel. Because I will use the team you see in the left corner right here, which only consists of Bandless One Pokes. And I got the idea for this team because I was team building for a serious team, and I got I saw the huge amount of Bandless One Pokes, or Pokes in the Bandless One, and I was surprised by some, and I didn't even thought that some of them were there. For example, Superior, I thought about BOU, Zygarde thought would be UU, and then I thought, let's build a team with only Bandless Pokes. There's a pretty good amount in it, so you can build a good team, or at least I hope so. I wasn't able to test it, this will be the first match with it. And yeah, show them people that Bandless Pokes are not weaker than any OU Poke. They deserve their place in the OU tier. So let's get over our team. First we got Wizard, the Mega Alakazam with Psychic, Focus Blast, Shadow Ball and Substitute. Substitute because once Mega Alakazam is behind the Substitute, 1 to 2 Pokes will die on the opponent's team. Nobody likes dealing with it. And I love putting Substitute on fast threatening mons which aren't that bulky. That's why I've substituted on Mega Alakazam. It's very good. Next we got Schlange, the Superior, which I said was very surprised wasn't OU already. He's too good for UU, I agree. Sometimes he's even too good for OU, depending on the team, but yeah. He is banlist, I was surprised with that, and I want to use him. I never used Superior in life so far. So here's Schlange, with Leaf Storm, Hidden Power, Fire, Dragon Pulse, and Synthesis. Synthesis over Giga Drain, because it can, that way you can avoid Sucker Punches from Bishop, other pokes, and heal up, switch out, and blah blah blah, you know the jazz. Next we got Turgotan, the physically defensive Togekiss with Air Slash, Heal, Belt, Defog, Softbolt, kind of standard set. Next we got Lustim, you know him, you love him, from last live I uploaded Play Rough, Toxic, Thunder Wave, Spikes, the double status is very nice, Thunder Wave for slowing threats down, Toxic some walls, Spikes for hazard stacking. And this time a special defensive one because I got physically defensive Turgotan. Next we got Crabapedi, the Choice Bandit Crawdon with Crab Hammer, Knockoff, Aqua Jet and Superpower, which is like the perfect wallbreaker without the Choice Bandit. With a Choice Bandit he's even stronger without setup, and I need some strong priority, and Aqua Jet, Choice Bandit, Crabapedi was laughing at me and I couldn't resist using it. The speed of this bit you see here is to outspeed No Speed Heatran. Yeah, it's No Speed Heatran to outspeed this. And yeah, the rest in attack, Adamant Nature, just for maximum damage output. At last we got Duck, the Dragon Dancing Zygarde with Earthquake, Extreme Speed for even more strong priority, and Outrage because look at this poor guy, he doesn't have arms, he doesn't get Dragon Claw. The Thalumberry, max speed, max attack, Adamant. I was kind of surprised to see him BL because I didn't saw him that much in UU, but if the people there think it's so good, I will prove myself that it's good enough for OU. So, like I said, I couldn't have any test battles with this team. So, let's hope we do fine. Click the look for battle button and hope for the best. Let's see if it takes too long, I will pause it. It won't take so long. Take a zip and we got a team. Good luck, have fun. Let's see. First, leads. Starbreaker Mew could be a lead. Heatran could be a lead. Who can handle both? Because Zam can handle both pretty much. Yeah, because Zam can handle both. And Zam has a pretty good matchup with his team of this. Leads of Heatran, okay. He makes a focus blast and switch out. Or he goes for rocks or something like this. I will go for my sub. Can't go for a fire attack because I trace his flash fire. Let's see if he knows that. I will go for focus blast. Please hit. I hate using focus blast, but you need the coverage on Mega Alakazam. And yeah, I can just always pray once you click it. Come on. Nothing on this team likes Mega Alakazam. Shadow ball, focus blast, psychic, and but busy. I trace his flash fire. Like I said. Yeah, pretty bad for him. What did he say in chat? Shoot. Yeah, pretty much shoot. Let's see, that's 230, 80, this will do a third of what I did with focus. I need to do with this next focus blast. Okay, he forfeited right away. Yeah, he saw his huge weakness to Mega Alakazam on his team. But yeah, first win with a mono BL team. Let's get some more. This doesn't really count. This was just, he had a really weak team to Mega Alakazam, but yeah, that's your team is always weak to one poke or two or a team idea your opponent has. Better realize it early than late. And we got our next team. Let's click the good luck have fun. And let's see, who will he lead to? Probably Heatran again? I guess Heatran will its lead. Yeah, okay. Don't see anything. Maybe it's a fake, the Weavile for fake out. I will lead with Wizard again. Because I expect the Heatran. And maybe the same thing will happen again. Who knows? There's the Heatran. I will just do the same. Same procedure, because he can't hit me with fire type attacks. And he may switch out or get up rocks, which I don't, both don't really mind. Let's see, he goes for rocks, okay, so that goes as last time. I will click Focus Blast and pray again to hit it, please. Come on, hit, damn it, that, he goes for Lava Plume. What's wrong with these people? Both clicking Lava Plume on my Flashfire Alakazam, god damn it. Okay, we'll just go for Focus Blast, switch in and Sylveon. That's okay. He has a Hyper Voice. I could have expected this switch out. Can I take him? I have pretty good special defense. But do I want to take it is a better question. Because I outspeed Quick Attack will probably kill me. I outspeed this, and this Ice Shard. It's good versus this. Mm-hmm. I want to keep this. I should have predicted this. Go for Psychic. I was kind of. The first battle was getting me very comfortable. Comfortable? Is this the right word? I don't really know. And yeah, let's go for Spikes because he probably has the the Heal Bell. No need to toxic it. I doubt he can touch me. Wish Heal Bell protect Hyper Voice. Set to kind of run with Sylveon. Maybe he has the HP fire, but I'm specially defensive, so I can definitely take it. And he may go into Heatran. Yeah, there's a Heatran. Can I go into Alakazam again on you? Can I really be so cheeky? I will be so cheeky. I will try it. Go into Alakazam again. And fire off a Psychic this time, because yeah, can stay in Heatran. Maybe he can touch me. Flash Cannon won't do too much. And yeah, Hyper Voice on Sylveon. Should have gone from Psychic last time already. And to predict it. Damn it, he got me. Okay. Yeah, it was kind of obvious. And the first battle was thinking, make me feel too comfortable. I need to step up my game. This guy is way better than the last one, it seems. I will still. Maybe he doesn't want to take the damage and will go back into Sylveon. He will go back into Sylveon. Okay, I just go Focus Blast. Nope, and I missed again. Damn it. Two misses already! Damn it! I will go for Psychic because I'm dead to I can defog again. I can defog later with Turbine. This is the Conqueror, for example. We're just going to lose them again. And versus Heat, then if he goes to Heatran, I will switch into my Zygarde this time. Just Wish, okay, that's fine. Goes into Starmie, he may Rapid Spin, but he has Natural Cure. He has Natural Cure. But on the Rapid Spin, I will just switch into my Schlange. Goes into Heatran again, no problem, we'll get another Spike. This is dead to re-entry, so we go to my duck. I just saw he has no immunity to Earthquake. Once this Mega Evolves he has, but at the moment he has no. And last time is pretty nice since this team can take on this. This kind of. He can at least Thunder Raid everything. Switch on to Zygarde yet. What he does, Lava Plume. Don't burn, I have a Lumberry, but please don't burn, I want to keep my Lava Plume. May switch out into what? The Weavile probably? He won't love taking this EQ. Going to Conkeldurr 2. Let's go for EQ. Let's first go for EQ. I have the hazards up, at least more hazards than him. And Doffy can rewild take spikes, EQ, and... And the other thing? This can take... Ah, Sylveon is a problem. Sylveon is really a problem. I switched out 3 times into lost him. I think he will predict by now, and I will go for a DD. Ah, damn it, if he goes for Wish... I will go for EQ. But because if he goes for Wish... You can just protect and then I'm in a safe position at plus 1, I will still die and can't kill him. I will go for EQ again. Yeah, I was going for 3 times by now into my Glapty. I think he will predict this. He looks like a pretty competent player. So let's be a bit cheeky. Let's be a bit cheeky. Yeah! Oh, I killed him. That was a roll. Okay, that was a roll. I don't really know for what he did go. Maybe he did go for Hyper Voice. But yeah, that was min-max in my favor. And the Sylveon is dead, that's pretty cool. Sylveon was a threat to my team. I expect the Weavile or the Starmie come in now. Because Zygarde is pretty bulky. This can come on too, because if he has Ice Punch, but this is a free switch into my other Starmie. Probably go for Rapid Spin. Does he have the Destiny team? On the Rapid Spin, I will go into my. Into this. He has still the Heatran on too much health. I will go into my Cryo Patty. Then take any hit. I resist, or I'm immune to any if he doesn't have the damage. Please, people, don't do this to me. Okay, we'll probably go into Heat. Yeah, he has to go for into Heatran now. So I can go back into my Cryo Patty. Check my middle play because he may go for Ice Beam. Predict me to predict him. And like I said, already said, I'll speed. Standard no speed Heatran. There's the Heatran. Can double into my Cryo Patty. And nothing on its team wants to really take Crab Hammer. I'll go for Crab Hammer. I don't want. Knockoff is a really safe play too, but he has two pokes which take not so much damage from his Crab Hammer, even if it's adaptability choice span element. And Crab Hammer does even more damage. His only resistance is his Starmie. Which wouldn't like take a Crab Hammer from this. Goes into Kong, expect the knockoff, and Crab Hammer just kills it! Woo! Cryo Patty! That's what I want to see! Ah, the power! The pure power! Nice! Okay, we're doing good so far, We got already 2 dead. We switch in now. What do you want to switch in? Pinsir maybe? If he has a close combat? Yeah, this was his only way. Starmie. Because he knows, probably thinks I'm Choice Bennett once he saw that I killed him. Let's go into Lost Him on this. With some special defensive, and I can T-Wave anything now. Nothing would appreciate that. So T-Bolt, okay. Now I get a Para. Let's hope I don't get Para too often. Let's go for T-Wave. If I T-Wave the Heatran, it's still pretty nice. I take this. Because Heatran is just a free switch into my Zygarde again. Okay, he stays in. Let me T-Wave his Starmie. That's cool. Okay, just he has magic, but I can just switch out, of course. But I can reset up my spikes. Because if he rapid spins, he will lose life orb damage. That's why I personally don't really like life orb rapid spin. No, I get paradise. She gets paradise. Best turn. I get some leftovers. Let's get up spikes again. But yeah, I don't really like life opt rapid spin. Sometimes you have to run it. For example, on Sandrush Excadrill. With you don't really don't. Oh, he missed the hard one. That's annoying for him. Now we go for play rough. Getting this thing low. He has Hydro Pump, Thunderbolt, rapid spin. I doubt he has recover. So. Ah, he's Hidden Power something. Okay, he really doesn't have recover. Hidden Power Fire, it seems. Okay. What can I switch into this? Hydro Pump, Thunderbolt, Hidden Power Fire. Hidden Power Fire won't kill my Schlange, but he still has the Heatran. May go for a Hydro Pump, something. I want to keep this, that's for sure. What do I expect from him? Let's go into Duck. Because he's immune to Thunderbolt, resists the Hidden Power Fire. And the Hydro Pump would be bad, but I think I can take this. Okay, switch out. It would be Tran. Okay, nice. Nice. That I got right. Ah, okay, I didn't really predict that, but I take it. I take it. Just fire off the Earthquake again. But it still has no immunity to this. And Sami is dead, so the spikes are... Oh, Sami is not dead yet, but the spikes are pretty much here to stay. The steam is fine. It's doing fine. It's doing fine. It's doing fine. Nice. Let's see what he does. He will switch out into Pinsir. Okay, he can take the Earthquake for sure. Yeah, there it is. What will he do now? Mega Evolve, of course. And go for Return. Will Return kill me? I doubt it. I doubt it, really. How much does a plus one extreme speed do to Mega Pinsir? Oh, can I even live? A return from you? Zygarde, Bang Dance. Yeah, that's my investment. Return does maximum of 69%. Let's see, let's put extreme speed here. Plus one. Plus one, plus two. 57%. Okay, a plus one extreme speed will kill him. And he could kill me with return. It's a roll in his favor. Ah, damn it. I will go for extreme speed just for damage. A return will kill me for sure. Goes for SD for whatever reason. A quick attack won't be able to kill me, so two SD speeds will be able to pick him up. Okay, he goes for frustration, kills me. Still fine. Because he has no switch into Aqua Jet now. Yeah, the Starmie was his only switch in and he dies. And I can take quick attack from you. We go for Aqua Jet. This is still flat. I still have my Klefki and I have to pray to God to not get... Okay, he just attacks the Pinsir. Let's see what he switches in now. Switches in now. Going to... If he goes into Weavile, that's my answer. What's my answer to this? I don't really need to get the defog up at the moment. This wizard is still a worthy sack. Goes into Weavile. How much does a... I don't think I will kill him, but I will see how much it does. What do we have here? Crawdont. For your Wallbreaker, Adamant ability Life Up, no Choice Band. That is. Versus Weavile. Weavile over you Life Up. Aqua Jet will do 66 to 79%. Okay, can't knock him out yet. Probably go for Knockoff. It's like what they all do. So I can go into my Turgleton. Fire off an Air Slash, that's what I will do. Yeah. On the Turgleton. Does it still need this? How much does Ice Shot do to me from him? Ice Shot does 20%. Low kick, not even better. 20%, so it may kill me. If I switch into rocks. Get my defog off. Need damage on this. I first need damage on this. Let's go for Air Slash. Revile is a threat. He can kill Schlange, he can kill this, he can kill this with his solo. He can kill this. No, don't flinch, don't flinch! Ah, nice. That's enough damage. That's the damage I wanted. So let's go for defog if he may do something stupid. Yeah, I can go into my... It's still a threat. Still a threat. How much does it do to my... That would do an... I outspeed. Ice Crash would kill my... My Schlange. No doubt about it. No doubt about it. I need to T-wave it. I need to T-wave it. Or I risk that he knocks me out with Crawdont. I T-wave it. I try to T-wave it. We may go into Starmie, get a bit of my something. Low kick. Ice Crash, knock off. I'll go for Playruff. I predict the switch out, and if he stays in and I don't get paralyzed, I can kill him with Playruff. So I will do that, because I don't want to Starmie to come in. And Rapid Spin my Spike away. Because if I can kill the Starmie, and he goes into Heatran, I can get my second Spike up and kill the Weavile in the process, and then it's pretty much GG. Yeah, I think Playruff is the best player. I just has to hope to not get paralyzed. Yeah, it's like my only hope. Riga has only 2 hits in it. If I let him kill my... let him kill this and kill my superior, my Crawdot can still Aqua Jet everything to death. Aqua Jet this and can sack my Wizard and Crab Hammer this. Also, Ice Crash kills me. Okay, now I need to just need to sack my superior. Yeah, he's switching, he's dead to re-entry. So even if he switches out, it's no problem. Can just sack this, go for a Heathstorm. He will be dead. I can go into my Gravity Paddy. How much does a Choice Man Aqua Jet do to standard heat friend? Let's see your defensive. Aqua Jet at 8 will be boost 67 to 80%. Yeah, I won't kill him. So I need to sack my Alakazam. How much will Knockoff do? Knockoff will 81 to 96. But he may be speed invested in some way. No, he isn't. I already confirmed he all speed with the... I don't confirm, he's just switch out. Oh, he missed Ice Cream Crash, that's bad. That's bad. Now he has to go into Heatran and take some damage so I can risk the... What you call it, the Aqua Jet. I don't have to risk that he outspeeds for some reason and the miss on Crab Hammer. Yeah, my plan would still work even if he would hit, but yeah, that's it. Let's go Dragon Pulse. Yeah, it's hidden power fire, but I doubt it will kill me. It's no use in synthesizing up, because I still. I don't have to miss. Let's go, just go for Dragon Pulse. I need just some damage on Heatran, about 10%. Yeah, I can take this. He dies. Yeah, I can just go for Dragon Pulse on you, die to Life Orb. Then go into my Crab Paddy to finish up the game. Let's do this, let's keep Dragon Pulse. And this is a one game, nice, 2-1 games. One pretty fast one because of forfeit. But yeah, that's 54% Aqua Jet will kill for sure. Let's check it again. Yeah, Aqua Jet is not a roll. Unless he's some kind of physically defensive. Which would worry me. Knockoff will do more, no? Yeah, knockoff will do more. Knockoff does more than Aqua Jet, but then I risk his speed again. Yeah, again. I go Aqua Jet. Number one, he's standard Heatran. Why should you run something else in standard Heatran? I mean, if he runs something else in standard Heatran, he may even be speed invested, so I risk in both ways. Let's go for Aqua Jet. Let's hope my. Cancel a little bit more, the lag's pretty bad. Yeah, nice! GG! GG! BL team, you are working! Nice! Let's go for one more. There are 23 minutes, we can go for one more.
Ah! Endless, too strong!
Take a zip of something to drink again, and pick another team, and here it is. And he uses two bandits to poke too. Ah, there they are. Let's put them together. Good luck, have fun, GM, sir. This is Loki. Loki? I don't really know how I pronounce it. Okay, every time I see a Landorus, I expect the lead. Him to lead with Landorus. So I will lead with what? Is he Choice Scarf? He's probably defensive because he has nothing else to put up rocks. This is a problem for his team because, yeah, I have nothing really. Zygarde can take one hit, but I would need to go for Outrage. I don't know if it does enough. I expect the Landorus lead and I expect it to be physically defensive. So I can go to work. Okay, damage. Damn, that's damage. I can't afford to switch into Duck. I need that full health for the Talonflame. And if he goes for Hidden Power Ice, let's go into Lost him. He can take both. The Hidden Power Ice and the Thunderbolt. Limits for anything? He has a rapid spin on this. Let's go for a spike or toxic. Let's go for toxic. We want damage. Need damage on this. Thunderbolt. Maybe specs. Oh, this is the min max. I may lift the next one. These specs. I may just check a few specs. Let's go to Zygarde. Maybe assault this. Maybe. Easy assault this. His team could maybe try Scarf, because he doesn't have no Scarf on. Do I risk it? Do I risk it? EQ? May go into Talon Flame then. But it's score superior. I'll risk it. Okay, here's choice. That's confirmed, and get rid of his key. That's nice. What do you expect? There's outrage? Probably. And he forfeited. I don't know why he forfeited there. His team is still pretty threatening with a Talonflame. But yeah, I take it. And I think we can still go for one more. Yeah, we are 3-0 with our BLC crew. That's it.
BLC crew. BLC crew. BLC crew.
A BLC crew? I was on C too much. Damn it. Damn it, I messed up the cheerings.
BL crew. BL crew.
Yeah, it's way better to chant. Okay, one more. And then we're done. If we get one. Let's see if I pause it. 1, 2, 3. Yes, I pause it. Till we find one. I will see you later. And here we're back with a battle. I can't really see it because of the lag, but here we go. This is Planetel. Or Plane the. Planet Hell? Planet Hell! Planet Hell! Okay, there it is. Planet Hell. Let's hit him up with a good luck of thumb. And leads. Probably Mamoswine, I would guess. Or this for switching out with U-turn or Volt Switch. But I expect the Mamoswine lead. If he leads with Mamoswine, I will lead with my Wizard. And sub on the expected rocks. He doesn't rocks and just goes for EQ or something like this. He will break my sub, of course, but I can go on from there and switch out into something. Substitute. Because I can then go for a Psychic, and if he's sashed, I can kill him after that still. Let's see what he does. I think this was my best course of action. I may have lead with... Nice, that shoots out, which is even better. I can get him behind the sub. And hit him up with a Shadow Ball. Don't want to miss with Focus Blast. It's probably Mega. Could be Mega Slowbro, but I expect Mega Scissor. And he doesn't know if I have the HP Fire. Okay, he seems to be choice. Yeah, he's Life Orb. Okay. Hit him up with this. And now he probably goes for U-turn. It'll be U-turn probably. If I go into my last turn, he can take the U-turn best. I think Turgotan could take the U-turn even better, but I don't want to risk him going for Brutal Punch again and just wrecking my Turgotan here. The poor guy. Yeah. Could go for SD versus my Klefki. Alright, he has a boost damage. Predicted me. Go for T-Wave. Boost is pretty bad. I will go for T-Wave first. He set them an SD here. SD life off boost. That's a don't it's a common set. He stays in probably goes for SD, yeah, there's the SD. Damage on this first. Can let him allow to go to plus 4. Here something like this. Let's go to Cry Petty. Let's go into you first and get some damage off of this guy. Full punch right away. Okay. I need to go for Aqua Jet now. Bruce was pretty unexpected by me. If I see a Life Orb Scissor, I see the Sword Sense, yes, but Bruce I didn't saw coming. Okay, no, make this. I think I kill him now with an E-Speed from Duck. At least I should be able to. No resist that, but come on, it's Duck. I don't really. I doesn't even want to call it. Can go into Zygarde and kill him with an E-Speed. Yeah, I need to sack my Gravity there, but could have sacked Duck too. But these are only ones which can outspeed him with priority. Cool E-Speed. He may Hulk if E-Speed kills. Or something like this. Or how much a Bullet Punch does. I don't really know. If he wants to preserve this, he'll probably go into Bishop. I guess. Yeah, probably go to the Bishop. Not a team I BL crew likes to deal with, but I will see if I can handle it. I can see see if I handle it. Once I set up a DD with Duck, he has pretty much nothing to switch into it. Only if it's Sash Memo Swine, of course. Then he has a pretty safe switcher. Just can Icy Crash, Ice Charge me two times or something like this.
Ah, damn it. It's taking very long.
I will start time on him to tell him that I don't have time forever. And we'll see how he reacts.
Switch out into Bishop. My next switch would probably be nothing. God damn it. Would be nothing. I'd outspeed him. So he may go for Sucker Punch on me. Okay, just let Scissor die, which I take. Probably goes into Latias now. I would least expect. Into Mandu too. I have Mandu. I already named Mandu. Ice Ground. It's too good coverage for my team. Let's go for the ice attack. I will go into my Klefki. Then I can go into. What could I need this? He just goes straight for the EQ. And he's life off, okay. Which means I can go into Schlange. Fire off the Leaf Storm. Ice Shot won't kill me. I'm at full. He may go into Bishop, but then I can Synthesis and then hit him up, Hidden Power Fire. So we click Leaf Storm here. Yeah, that's my best course of action. I think that's the best course of action. Leaf Storming, Synthesizing. He predicted my switch this time with the EQ. So he may predict again to go for knockoff. Which would be pretty bad for me. Raikou outspeeds. It's done alright. What's the speed of Raikou? Raikou. 115, okay, it's faster than me. How much does a Hidden Power Ice do from Raikou? Let's go worst case scenario and say his choice specs. Versus my Zephyria with no investment. Why is the Korea Zephyria not implemented in this? HP Ice will do 76% max. So I can take this. If his choice makes, of course. So I can just fire off another Leaf Storm. I think I will do this. Yeah. I can take the Hidden Power Ice. Even if his stacks. Then he would need to go into Mammoth Swine. Just click Sword Switch, nice. Okay, would we switch into this? Can only switch in Bishop. Latios outspeed and kill with Dragon Pulse. This dies to Leaf Storm, this dies to Leaf Storm. If he goes into Bishop, I would need to. He goes into Latios, okay. Is this Scarf Latios? I don't think so, it's Scarf Latios. Maybe he wants to bait the Dragon Pulse for the Bishop. Yeah, do I speed it? I doubt it's Scarf Bishop. Latios, he has no way of removing hazards. Is this life or bruise? I don't think he has D4. I will go for Dragon Balls. It's my safest play. Everything he switches on dies to this. Yeah, everything he switches in dies to this. I will now die to an HP Ice, but I take it. Because the Bishop, I will Synthesis. If he goes into Raikou, I would need to switch out, because this thing really matches up well versus his team. I needed to kill Slowbro. He goes into Mammoth Swine, okay, it's a safe play too. He may just go for the Ice. He has to go for the Ice Run, that's what I'm now saying. I have no switch into this. This is nice, I need to go. If I sack this, I guess it's free switch into my Wizard. Trace the thick fat and then can take the ice shard and go on from there. I think that's the best play. Because... how can I get a slowpoke then? Would need a wizard then, but I don't think Shadow Ball is a one-hit KO. Turgon, what do I need you? For nothing, I will go into Turgon. Yeah, we're going. Turgon does nothing this game. Bishop kills him with Iron Head, he has the ice attacks. And Ryker has the electric attacks. Nothing really likes Turgon this time. I go for Air Slash. Just to get some damage. But can I don't think I can lift the Icicle Crash. Icicle Crash does double the damage than Ice Shard. Yeah, Icicle Crash will kill me. Icicle Spear I could lift if he only gets 2 hits, but not this way, not this way. After that I will need to switch into my Alakazam and go for Focus Blast. Because it will kill the Mammoth Spine and kill the Bishop if it will come in. Did I already go for sub with my Alakazam versus this guy? Yeah, I did already. Because Icicle Spear gets more than 2 hits, yeah. It kills me. Now I can go to Wizard, trace his thick fat. And go for Focus Blast. Yeah, I need to go for Focus Blast. And once this is dead, my Zygarde can have a good time versus team, I think. Nice. May do some... Nah, we'll go for Psychic, because if he goes into Bishop, I can still sub on the Sucker Punch and such. Yeah, I can still do this. You saw me going for sub, but these are some mind. I'd rather play mind games than risking hitting a Focus Blast. There's the Raikou, okay. Which is dead. What will you do now? Go into Bishop, probably. Set up a sub on you. Then I can wrap up this game. Ah, you already saw me going for sub. Ah, this is pretty bad. Ah, he's playing very good. He saw me going for sub. So if I hit him up with a Focus Blast right away, and because he expects my sub on the Sucker Punch, and I can kill him, that's like the pretty dream scenario. But if he Sucker Punches, if I miss and he kills me, that's pretty bad too. This game is intense. At least I can say this. Mega Alakazam is putting in the work at the moment. Goes to Slowpoke. Probably Kalk something. How much does a Shadow Ball do? I'm modest. How much does a Shadow Ball do to you? Alakazam? It probably won't kill. Because it is not stab. But he can kill me even. Slow bro. Shadow Ball's a 2-hit KO. Scald will break myself. Let me go for Shadow Ball. How much does Ice Shot from Mammoth Swine do? Oh, you feel get a trigger? Yeah, just say it. Yeah, you lose your life off if I have Thick Fat. Nope, not Paravolt. Thick Fat. Ice Shot does 23 to 28%. To 28, so I can lift the next ice shot. Attractive, right? Maybe 28, huh? This is I think. 24 to 29. Oh god, it's a roll. It's a roll in my favor. It's a roll in my favor. At least I can say this. Ooh, this is getting intense. This is getting intense. If it goes into Bishop, I still have the thing that what you call it? Bishop, okay. Now is the moment of truth. He knows I have Substitute, but did he forget that? Or did he go for Sucker Punch? Focus Blast. I expect him to know that I have Substitute. I did go for it before. Set Focus Blast and hope for the best. This game depends pretty much on this play. He goes for Sucker Punch. I could have subbed and... Damn it. Damn it! How much does Ice Shard do to... Those one is here, due to my Zyka. I think I can take one Ice Shard. Barely. Can take it barely. If he's... Ah, damn it. I can take it barely. Just can't take it. Need to go into this. Does he think Ice Shard kills me? Ah, defense on this again. Okay, if he goes for Sucker Punch and I go for Dragon Dance. It's my like, my only weapon, but if he doesn't go for Sucker Punch, I go for EQ. It's game if he goes for Sucker Punch and I go for EQ. If he go for how much plus do I need to kill him with an E-Speed? Screen speed, let's put it here. He's at how much percent? 71. 71. And then plus 2. Then plus 2, I have a very good chance to kill him with an extreme speed. At plus 1, not. That's my. If he doesn't go for Sucker Punch and I go for EQ, my best pick for Dragon Dance. Need to go for Dragon Dance. If I get 2 Dragon Dances up, it's pretty much GG. Only if he goes to 2 Sucker Punch, of course. Go for 1 Dragon Dance. No, I didn't go for Sucker Punch. Okay, this man. Okay, but now, another knockoff won't kill me. Just Iron Head 2 from Fisher. This may still be possible, guys. This may still be possible. Iron Head. That's 39%. I need to go to plus 2. That's a bad thing. Do I not speed you? Yeah, I'll speed you. Next speed. Now I'll speed you for sure. Sucker Punch will do the same. I can live a Sucker Punch. Into the Sucker Punch. We'll go for Dragon Dance. We'll go for Dragon Dance. And then for EQ. It's my only way of winning. It's really my only way of winning, so. Ah, he goes for an attack again. And it killed me. How did it kill me? Didn't I have Park wrong? Element of. Ah, yes, I forgot the life orb. But yeah, it's GG now. I would have gone for EQ there. It would be GG either way. He never clicked Sucker Punch, that sealed the game. It was still a good game. I give it to him. But now, yeah, I go for Synthesis. If he should choke away and go for a Sucker Punch, would be pretty funny. But I doubt it. He's playing good, very good this game. So, I can go for Sucker Punch, yeah. There's a knockoff. The next knockoff will do... Still do about 60%, so I can synthesis up on you like forever. Yeah, so I kill you and die myself. Yeah, that's GG. Was a very good game. I had several chances to win, but he never let me win, or I got my prediction wrong. So, GG. I think that's all. I think I've shown that all Bandless Pokes are still worthy in staying in OU, and they are very viable in OU. Don't use them. Use them. They need some love up and down in BL. Like, they aren't used enough to be in OU, but they're too good to UU. They belong nobody. Give them Pokes some love. Give them some love. Yeah, but that's all for me. If you liked what you saw, hit me up with a like, comment, or even subscribe. Hit me up on Twitter and Facebook, and I will see you next time. Ciao.